Mine is a little longer than yours. It starts with an alchemist. A great alchemist once created Subject One. Subject One was her proudest achievement, and successfully blended into human society. No one ever would have thought that this friend of theirs was in fact a synthetic human. However, unbeknownst to Subject One, the alchemist had tried the same experiment many times before he had come into being. Some of the rejects from failed experiments had been discarded, but had not died. Subject Two was one such failed experiment. He was swallowed by a great dragon that came to rest upon a snow-swept mountain. Many years later, he was resurrected by the dragon's mysterious power. He saw all kinds of people on the mountain, including Subject One, who had somehow miraculously blended in among them. Never in Subject Two's wildest imagination had he thought it possible for experimental life forms such as they to deceive everyone so successfully. He saw the way humans accepted Subject One as a friend, witnessed their affection as they addressed him by name. This was what Subject Two wanted. Now, all that Subject Two desired was to replace Subject One and take the joy of his existence for himself. Subject Two began to unfold his plan. He stole Subject One's books and notes and studied all that Subject One had learned from the alchemist. Subject Two was highly intelligent, and he learned quickly. He changed his face into an exact replica of Subject One's face. Then, he found a plant with mimicry capabilities and transformed it using dragon blood and alchemy. And so, not only did Subject Two transform his own appearance to perfectly match that of Subject One, he also created a third entity, Subject Three.
What? There's three of them now?
But Subject Two wanted to become a perfected human. So, he erased a mark on both his and Subject Three's necks, for these marks were symbols of imperfection.